Awesome. Well, guys, I'm Katie from Hipsters on the Coast, and we're here today with Elaine Chase from Magic and Wizards. This is exciting. Thanks for talking with us today. How are you?
I'm doing great. Thanks for having me on.
So we're here to talk with Elaine about Arena, a replacement for Duels, kind of. So do you want to tell us a little bit about the differences between Arena and Duels for the people who haven't had a chance to check it out yet?
Yeah, so Magic the Gathering Arena is our new digital offering for Magic. It takes the full authentic rule set for Magic the Gathering and all of our frontless card sets and lets you play the best possible experience of Magic in the digital environment for our current cards.
That's awesome. So what do you expect to see between the differences in Arena and MTGO over the next year or so?
So for now, Magic Online has a vibrant community that plays cards from throughout Magic's history in lots of different formats, and that system isn't going anywhere. We're really taking the opportunity for MTG Arena for it to focus on delivering the best frontlist experience we possibly can be. So when it goes into beta, we'll be looking at having standard and then moving into draft and sealed, and we're going to get that experience to be the best it can.
That's awesome. What do you see for the long term, like 5 years from now? What do you expect to be the differences between the crowd using Arena and the crowd using MTGO?
Honestly, that depends an awful lot on what the audience wants. We're putting out a couple different ways to play Magic, and we're going to let the fans tell us what they like and what they don't like and how they want to optimize, and we're going to figure out where to go from there.
Well, that's pretty awesome to hear. So do you expect that possibly Modern, Legacy, Vintage, or EDH might be on Arena in the long term? Obviously, I use the word might.
Nothing's off the table, but as I said before, we're really going to focus on getting that standard frontlist experience right first.
That's really awesome. And I've played Arena now, and I see that there's a lot of animation into it, which isn't always mobile friendly. Do you guys expect to have a more mobile friendly version of Arena in the long term with less animations?
Hopefully. So we're building it on Unity, which means it's very flexible. We're getting PC right first. And then once we do that, we'll figure out where we go in other platforms.
That's awesome. And so you do plan to use this as like an esport equivalent to other games like Hearthstone?
Absolutely, esports is very important to MTG Arena. We've built it to be fun to watch and fun to stream and make it be really engaging.
That's really fantastic. And so if it does start to take over MTGO a little bit, what do you expect to tell the people who are invested in MTGO? I know that's a long-term dream. Do you guys have plans for that?
As I said, right now, we're not looking at Magic Online going anywhere. It has a vibrant community that we're going to continue to support. It's still going to have content releases. It's still going to have updates, and we're going to support it.
Awesome. So are there plans to improve MTGO if there's no plans, if it ends up staying as it is?
Magic Online has gone through just a constant quality improvement over time, which I think our fans have noticed and recognized, and we're going to continue that same level of support for it.
Awesome. Do you think it's possible that having two different digital platforms could have a negative impact on Magic as an esport or in the digital space?
So here's the great thing about Magic the Gathering. You can play it literally hundreds of different ways, right? I don't think anybody looks at tabletop and says, gee, is the commander audience going to split your player base and so it's not going to work anymore? No, right? The beauty of Magic is that you can play it any way you want to play it. And that's what we're offering between tabletop, Magic Online, and MTG Arena.
Well, you're not going to hear me arguing on that. And then to step away from Arena as a second, you're the VP of Magic and you're also a woman. You've been with the company a really long time, which, like, yes, go girls. But so do you feel sometimes as a woman you feel obligated to help open the door more for other women in the space, maybe as players, content creators, or just employees even?
I do feel a sense of responsibility, but it's not just because I'm a woman. It's really because I want everyone to enjoy Magic. And when I say everyone, I really mean everyone. We tried our best to make an inclusive game where you can see yourself in the game, where you're welcome in our communities, where you can see yourself in our coverage and in our players and in our staff.
That's awesome. And do you have anything as the brand manager to say that you would love to say to the community? Since you have a Twitter, but you don't talk directly to the community a lot. You leave a lot of that up to Trick and Mark, which makes sense. But do you have anything you'd like to say? Because we have had a lot going on in the community lately.
We do. Honestly, the thing I want to say the most is as we go into Magic's 25th anniversary, which is outstanding, I want to say thank you, because Magic has been around for 25 years because of all of you and all of your love and all of your passion and you spreading the love and getting new people into the game, and we couldn't be here without you. So thank you for 25 amazing years, and here's to 25 more.
Yes, please. And one last question then. If you have any hints about what's going on for 25th anniversary, I know we got that VIP party tonight, but I'd love some sneak peeks to share with our with our audience.
Well, the biggest sneak peek this weekend, you saw yesterday.
I know.
And that was the preview of Iconic Masters in a real old school pre-release where nobody knew what they were going to open up. It was super exciting.
That was super exciting. What's your favorite part about Iconic Masters?
Well, I'll have to say that it's the new art on the five dragons from Kamigawa. I was on R&D during Kamigawa, and I was a part of that team, and that's honestly my proudest bit of my 4 years in R&D was having a hand in the creation of those five dragons. So
awesome. Well, then,
can I just ask people to sign up for the closed beta?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah, all right. So the last thing is, if you want to get your hands on MTG Arena, please sign up for the closed beta. Go to playmtgarena.com.
Well, thank you so much for joining us, Elaine. It was great talking to you.
It was really great talking to you. Thanks.
All right. Thanks, guys. Talk to you soon.